Hello, my name is Shadi Ratsouk. In this video, we will talk about generating rebars with Rebar Modeler and discuss some use cases by generating rebars. Let's get started. For the demonstration of rebar tool, I prepared the shape family where I modeled several rebar shapes using the shape tool. Now that the family is loaded into the project, I can use Rebar tool and select the path. The Rebar dialog will pop up and the first rebar set is ready to be configured. First of all, I will select the proper shape family, then click the start and end of the path. You can use placements for the start end of the path in case the path is a SBIM axis. Define an offset for the start end of the path and pick a host for the system. You can also choose a bar type and spacing for rebar set. When you are done defining the first set, click on the plus to create a new set. All the previous settings are preserved, and all you have to do for the new set is to change the shape and the properties as desired. You can choose between longitudinal or transverse as a kind of rebar set. The Model tab provides a simplified presentation of the defined rebar sets. You can check the definition and parameters of the available rebar sets before being generated in the model. You can change the diameter, layout, and spacing of a rebar set using the Edit tool or in element properties in Revit. To add a segment length afterwards, you can open the corresponding shape family and use Edit Shape tool. Selecting an additional reference will add a new segment automatically for the shape. I will do the same for the shape on the left side and then load the family into the project. In this case, it's not necessary to refresh the whole system, but only the affected rebar sets using Refresh Instance tool. Now let's discuss some use cases and advantages from using Rebar Modeler. Due to parametric offsets and parametric modeling, you can assign these parameters not only to axis variables, but also to host rebar cover parameter, even if the host is a native Revit structure element. Let's jump to Revit to clarify this point. We have a SBIM component that has a rebar cover parameter. It has also variable height. I've prepared a shape family. It's a duplicated and renamed version of the profile family of this component. I created a family parameter named rebar cover and modeled the shape using this parameter as an offset from references as shown before. Let's load the family and generate a rebar set. pick the shape family and select the host. Now set the variation type of rebar cover parameter to variable. The available access variables and host rebar cover parameter are listed. When the shape family is the same or duplicated version of host parameter family, you can simply activate the option Inherit Parametric from Host, and all the values and variation type of parameters are going to be inherited. The parameters in shape family and host family must have identical name to be inherited. Another advantage is the ability to use a line, host age, or of course SBIM axis as a path, depending on the situation and the geometry. In this example, you can use Rebar Modeler to create edge reinforcement for this tunnel using a model line as a path. The U-shape is modeled in individual family and will be distributed orthogonal to the path. Optionally, you can model the shape using shape handle points to control the width. In this case, these points must be assigned to the proper edge. With Rebar Modeler, you can create fan rebar with radial arrangement simply by defining an angle for the start or end of the path. Let's take a look in Revit. This is a native Revit structural element. I'm using a shape family where I used parameter A for legs length. And shape handle points for the width. In this case, these points must be assigned to the proper edge. I will go to Model tab and define an angle for the start of the first set. When you are using SBIM axis with placements for the start end of the path, placements rotations are going to be adapted automatically. You need to activate rotations to consider angle value. I will add a new set and adjust the start end of the path. And deactivate apply rotations. The same for the third set, but the angle is for the end of the path. At the end, I would like to mention that Rebar Modeler can overcome challenges by reinforcement modeling, not only for infrastructure geometries, but also for buildings, such as rebar set distributed in one plane, and rebar sets with non-variable legs in curved elements with variable geometries.